This man accused of kidnapping and killing a 9-year-old girl, Jorge Guerrero Torres, did not take that deal today after a judge ruled key evidence in the case must be thrown out.
9-year-old Diana Alvarez went missing from her home in San Carlos Park back in 2016. Investigators didn't find her body for 4 years. NBC2's Sarah Metz is live and local tonight at the Lee County Courthouse. Sarah?
Yeah, the defense told the judge that they thought they had an agreement, that is, until things officially got started. That's when the defense told the judge that Guerrero Torres was having a hard time understanding some of the language in that plea deal. And after two recesses and further trying to explain that language, they ultimately decided that he just was not ready to take that deal. All of this happening while Diana Alvarez's family was holding on tightly to a picture of the little 9-year-old girl inside the courtroom. From their pleas,
anything that you guys know about my daughter, let me know.
She says that it's very difficult because sometimes she'll walk into her house and she'll say her name knowing that she's not there.
To a potential plea deal that's now off the table.
An agreement at this point?
We do not have an agreement at this point, Your Honor. What happened is some statutory language needed to be incorporated, and we're going over that with Mr. Guerrero Torres. This is a very narrow issue.
But not something that could be hashed out today, according to Guerrero Torres's attorney. We were the only ones who talked to Diana Alvarez's mother, Rita Hernandez, before heading into chambers. She said she cannot fathom a plea deal for the man she believes is her daughter's killer. My daughter, she didn't ask for somebody to do that to her. Guerrero Torres never admitted to taking the 9-year-old, just to taking pornographic pictures of her. He's already been sentenced to 40 years for that.
He would go to her room, he says he would get those pictures.
Last month, a judge ruled what happened during some of these interrogations from right after Alvarez went missing years ago.
He says he doesn't know if she's dead or alive.
Should be thrown out. The judge was concerned about Guerrero Torres's ability to understand English, and his Miranda rights weren't read immediately or translated verbatim. His attorneys have fought that he cannot face a death penalty due to his intellectual disability. Now it's the same confusion and concern regarding a plea deal, something both the state and his defense attorney thought they could potentially see today. The judge encouraged them to keep negotiating for another 10 days. That's either when they will have another plea hearing or a pretrial conference.
Sarah, what have Diana Alvarez's parents said? I know you talked to her mother before and after court today. We heard a little of that.
Yeah, Kelly, we did. And I'll tell you what, she is extremely angry. She wants this to go to trial. She wants to know what happened to her little 9-year-old girl. She wants answers. Just take a listen to what she said after court. What he did to my daughter does not have any forgiveness, no forgiveness. I'm asking for justice because he didn't accept what they offered him. So on Friday, they told me they were going to give him that offer, but I told them the one who lost her daughter was me. So again, on March 14th at 8:30 a.m. right here in the courtroom, we will be there, NBC2 will be, and we will let you know what happens, whether that be a plea hearing or a pretrial conference. We're local today from the Lee County Courthouse. Sarah Metz, NBC2.